students, good morning. In yesterday's class, we completed process of mitosis. Fine, huh? Its notes were remaining, so we'll write down those notes. Huh? After that, we'll see the next point, that is how the overall cell cycle it is controlled. Fine, huh? So that is the regulation of cell cycle. And in tomorrow's class, we'll see meiosis. You know that both these lessons are there for your major test. Hmm? Day after tomorrow, we will complete the meiosis. Fine. Hmm? Already, I hope that you have started the revision of cell division, because students, you are not asking me any doubt. Huh? And remember, paper is not so easy. Fine. Hmm? So you have to do a lot of practice for both these lessons. Lessons have a lot of depth. Okay, number of concepts are there, so you have to revise both the lessons for major test. Fine. Hmm? So let's write down some important points for mitosis. Okay, as you know that already its initial part we have taken, that there are two phases. First, that is karyokinesis, where nuclear division takes place, and the second step, that is cytokinesis. Okay, overall process of mitosis involve four stages, that is prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. Okay, so let's start with the first phase, that is prophase. Okay, the first phase, which is known as prophase. Now during prophase, let's see which types of events occur. The first event, as you know that prophase, it is the first phase after interphase, because we know that there is a G1 phase, S phase, G2 phase. G1, S and G2. Okay, these three phases, they constitute the interphase. So prophase, it is the immediate phase after interphase. Okay, so this is the first phase after interphase. Fine. Then it is the longest phase of mitosis. Fine. Huh? So prophase, it is the longest phase of mitotic cell division. Huh? As we discussed, which events takes place? There is a condensation of chromatin. Huh? So initiation of condensation of chromatin. So each chromosome appears doubled. Why doubled? Why it appears doubled? Because during S phase, DNA has replicated. So that replicated chromatin also remain attached to the same centromere. So now here each centromere, okay, it attaches to the two chromatids. So these two chromatids are known as sister chromatids. Fine. Appears double. Consist of two coil sister chromatids. Consist of two coil sister chromatids attached to same centromere. Fine. Their ends are not visible in early prophase. So chromosomes appear like a ball of wool. Okay, so this stage, it is known as spireme stage. S-P-I-R-E-M-E. Okay, I told you that just when there is a beginning of process, then what happened? Chromatin begins to condense. But still the sister chromatids, they are not distinctly separated from each other. So it just look like a ball of wool. So this stage of chromatin, it is known as spireme stage. Fine. Next point, chromatin fibers become shorter and thicker. Chromatin fibers become shorter and thicker due to coiling and foldings. Okay, and get condensed into thread-like chromosomes in late prophase. Obviously, I have shown you yesterday at the beginning, just condensation begin, and by the end of this, they are distinct thread-like longer structure. Then what happened? Nuclear membrane disintegrate. Okay. Nuclear membrane disintegrate and disappears in cytoplasm along with what happened? Disappearance of nucleolus also. So nucleolus disappears. Then your cell organelle, that is Golgi, endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes, they also disappear. So Golgi, disappears, because right now there is no need of this cell organelles, disappears. Then what happened? Centrioles, they duplicate, which are already duplicated centriole, they move toward opposite pole. This is for the animal cells. Okay, so centrioles separate and move toward centrioles separate and move toward opposite poles. And then what happened? Around each centriole, ester rays are formed due to gelation of proteins. So these many events occur during prophase. Now, how can we draw its diagram? Yesterday I have shown you. I am drawing here. You can draw after this. Suppose this is a cell. Now, when cell enters the prophase or before that, nuclear membrane is intact still. Nucleolus is present, chromatin in the form of thread, cell organelles, I'm drawing specifically here centrioles, centrioles are duplicated. Now when cell enters in prophase, then what happened? Nuclear membrane disintegrate, nucleolus also, and this chromosome, they become thinner and longer and they look like a ball. So there is a condensation of chromatin begin. So like this we can observe. Okay, so this happened during prophase. Huh? Now yesterday I told you, in case of plant cell, centrioles are absent. Fine. Huh? So based on that, mitosis, it could be unastral or amphiastral. I told you astral or amphiastral, and second, that is unastral. So this point also you mentioned in the prophase. Unastral mitosis, unastral mitosis, and second one, astral mitosis, unastral mitosis and astral mitosis. Unastral mitosis means the mitosis in which astral or the centrioles are absent. Okay, so in plants, centrioles are absent, so there is no astral formation. In plants, centrioles are absent, so no asters, okay, or no astral rays are formed. Okay, so mitosis of plants, it is known as unastral mitosis. Okay, astral mitosis, it is also known as amphiastral. Obviously it is in animals. Okay, in animals centrioles are present, so astral rays are formed. Astral rays are formed from, they are formed from, astral rays are formed from centrioles. Okay, so these are the two types of mitosis based on whether centrioles are present or not. Now that was the first phase, that is prophase. Okay, now let's see about second phase, that is metaphase. Okay, the second one, metaphase, where metaphase plate it is formed. Metaphase, metaphase, let's see which events occur during this. So at the beginning of metaphase, there is a complete disintegration of nuclear envelope and nucleolus. Okay, the disappearance of nuclear membrane, which began in prophase, it completes when cell enters in metaphase. So complete disappearance of nuclear membrane and nucleolus. Chromosomes arranged on equatorial plane. Chromosomes arranged on equatorial plane. Chromosomes arrange on equatorial plane. Then what happens? Spindle fiber attached to kinetochore. Spindle fibers attach to kinetochore. Spindle fiber attached to kinetochore. Condensation of chromosome is completed. So I told you at this stage, chromosomes are in their full shape. Condensation of chromosome is completed. Condensation of chromosomes is completed. Condensation of chromosome is completed. Chromosomes can be easily observed under microscope. Chromosomes can be easily observed under microscope. Okay, each chromosome now clearly shows two sister chromatids. Each chromosome shows two sister chromatids. each chromosome shows two sister chromatids. As I told you, the spindle fibers are of two types. Okay, I'll just rough this. I don't know whether downside you are able to see or not. Spindle fiber, they could be continuous or discontinuous. Spindle fibers could be chromosomal or discontinuous. Chromosomal or discontinuous. Spindle fibers could be chromosomal or discontinuous. Now, which are those? These are these spindle fibers which have come from poles, okay, and attached to the centromere or to the kinetochore. So they run from pole to chromosome or pole to centromere. Pole to centromere. And the second one, that is supportive or continuous. Supportive or continuous. Supportive or continuous. They run from pole to pole. Okay, so such type of spindle fibers, they do not attach to centromere. So they run from pole to pole. Fine. So now here, as I told you, their arms are directing toward the pole. So they have arranged in such a way that arms are projecting or directing towards poles. Arms are directing towards poles. Okay, so already diagrams yesterday we have drawn, same diagram you can use for this. Okay, now the third phase, that is anaphase. Third phase, anaphase. You have to draw respective diagram also. You can refer the yesterday's lecture for that, so that we will not waste our time now. So anaphase, it is the smallest phase of mitosis. Okay, chromosome splits lengthwise. Now here what happened, the central spindle fibers, they contract. So it causes splitting of centromere. Fine. So spindle fibers contract. Spindle fibers contract. Okay. Centromere splits lengthwise. And chromatids are pulled toward opposite poles. Chromatids are pulled toward opposite poles. Okay. Chromatids are pulled toward opposite poles. Fine. Interzonal fibers disappear, or your continuous fibers, they disappear. Interzonal fibers disappear. Okay. Now for this, 30 ATPs are required to pull one chromosome to the another pole. Fine. So that much energy consuming process it is. Fine. 30 ATPs to carry a chromosome. 30 ATPs to carry a chromosome to a pole. Okay. And in the last stage, or at the late anaphase, both the sister chromatids, okay, they reach to the opposite pole. So at late anaphase, late anaphase chromatids reach to the opposite poles. And then what happened? Late anaphase, after that, there is a beginning of cytokinesis. Okay, cytokinesis starts. So at later stages, this cytokinesis or the process of cytokinesis starts. At late cytokinesis begins. It is completed after telophase. Fine. Now after anaphase, there is a telophase. After anaphase, the fourth stage, that is telophase, where events are exactly reverse of prophase. So telophase. Okay. Now here what happened? This is the last phase, okay, of mitosis. So chromosomes uncoil again. Chromosomes uncoil and lengthen, uncoil and lengthen, aggregate together to form a mass, aggregate together to form a mass or ball. Again, what happened? Nuclear membrane and nucleolus reappears. So nuclear membrane and nucleolus reappears. Fine. So nuclear membrane and nucleus reappears and your astral rays and spindle fibers, they are absorbed in cytoplasm. So spindles and astral rays, spindle and astral rays are absorbed in cytoplasm. So they are absorbed again in cytoplasm. Fine. So the events of telophase, they are exactly reverse of prophase. Now after telophase, what happened? After telophase, there is a cytokinesis. So as we discussed yesterday, cytokinesis in plants is different from cytokinesis of animals. In one, it takes place from central to peripheral. In another, it takes place from peripheral to central. Now let's see how cytokinesis takes place. So cytokinesis. What is mean by cytokinesis? Cytokinesis is nothing but the division of cytoplasm. Now in those four stages, nuclear material has divided into two. Now the time is to divide the cytoplasm equally. So division of cytoplasm, it is known as cytokinesis. So cytokinesis, it is division of cytoplasm. When it begins? It begins in late prophase. It begins in late prophase. Fine. Now let's see how it takes place in animals and in plant cells. So cytokinesis in animals. How it takes place? It takes place by formation of constriction and furrow. Okay, so it takes place from periphery toward the center. So by formation of constriction and furrow. Yes. Now microfilament form peripheral ring. Microfilaments form peripheral ring. For peripheral ring, okay, just below the plasma membrane, just below the plasma membrane, and then the contraction of this ring brings about the constriction. Contraction of peripheral ring, contraction of peripheral ring, furrow forms from outside to inside, furrow forms from outside to inside, okay, it just grows a little bit deeply, and thus separating the parent cytoplasm in two, okay, so furrow forms from outside to inside, this furrow grows deeply, or furrow extends deeply, and cell gets divided into, cell divides into two, okay, so this type of cytokinesis is known as centripetal. This is known as centripetal, obviously, as it takes place toward the center, from periphery towards central, that is known as centripetal. Okay, so in case of animal cell, cytokinesis takes place in centripetal manner. We'll draw a simple diagram for this. Suppose this is the parent animal cell. Okay, already two nuclei are formed. Okay, then what happened? These microtubules, they arrange in the form of a ring-like structure. Then there is a contraction. Okay, that result in formation of furrow from its membrane. So a little furrow is formed. Okay, and then this furrow extends ahead, thus resulting in separation of two cells. Fine. So in this way, in animal, furrow formation results in cytokinesis. Fine. Now let's see how in animals cytokinesis takes place. So in animals, as you know, in case of plants, as you know, there is a cell wall. Fine. So cell wall material, it is first deposited, cell plate it is formed, and then it extends from center to the periphery, so that is known as centrifugal. So cytokinesis begins from the center and then it proceeds toward periphery, so that type of cytokinesis, it is known as centrifugal type of cytokinesis. Fine. So now we will write down for plants, how in plants cytokinesis takes place. In plants, so cytokinesis takes place by cell plate formation, constriction is not possible because of presence of cell wall. Constriction is not possible because of presence of cell wall. Okay, because of presence of cell wall, constriction is not possible. Okay, Golgi vesicles and spindle tubules arranged. Many Golgi vesicles and spindle tubules arrange themselves on equator, to form phragmoblast. Okay, to form phragmoblast. Okay, so the basic material, it is formed of your Golgi vesicle and the spindle fibers. Okay, spindle fiber tubules get arranged on the equator of cell, so that basic material is known as phragmoblast. Fine. Then after this, what happened? After this, membranes of endoplasmic reticulum, they also merge with this phragmoblast. Fragments of ER, fragments of ER also deposits, also deposits in phragmoblast, also deposit in phragmoblast. Membrane of Golgi vesicle fuse to form membrane of Golgi vesicles, fuse to form a plate-like structure, fuse to form a plate-like structure that we call as cell plate. Plate-like structure called cell plate. Fine. So cell plate it is formed. Okay. Then what happened? As you know, the cell plate it is rich in calcium and magnesium pectin. So these Golgi vesicle then release calcium and magnesium pectin. So Golgi vesicles secrete, Golgi vesicles secrete calcium and magnesium pectate. Okay, and then the cell plate gets modified into middle lamella. Cell plate modifies into middle lamella. Cell plates get modified into middle lamella. Okay, so this type of separation or cytokinesis is known as centrifugal. So cytokinesis is said to be centrifugal because this is toward periphery. Fine. So one simple diagram you can show as in Kittlowfer's, already two cells are formed. First this Golgi vesicles, then cell plate, okay, and then this extends toward periphery separating two cells. Okay, so cell plate it is formed. Okay, and the cell plate it is deposited at the center, and from center it extends toward the periphery. So this type of cytokinesis is known as centrifugal type of cytokinesis. In case of animal cell, it is centripetal. If question come for MCQ, then in animal cell cytokinesis is centripetal. In plant cells, it is centrifugal. Fine. So these are the stages of mitosis. Fine. Now I hope you all have understood four phases, that is prophase, metaphase. I told you, if these phases are not clear, you won't be able to understand stages of meiosis. Okay, so these are stages of mitosis. Fine. Now after this, one small part we will see what is the, or in what way regulation of cell division it is done. So there is a part of regulation of cell division. Fine. I told you that there are some checkpoints. Now what is mean by checkpoints? Okay, wherever we go, we find some checkpoints or some hurdles to see whether all things are happening properly or not. Cell cycle or cell division is a very important event for cell. Cell doesn't want to offer any type of damage or any type of problem during cell division. So for that, it takes all the necessary measures which are required. So these are known as checkpoints. There are some protein molecules which are involved in that. They check all the materials which are properly present in cell or not, which are required for cell division, then only it allows the cell to progress toward the next phase of cell division. So there is a regulatory mechanism in cell division, whether it is mitosis or whether it is meiosis, it is same. Now let's see what is the regulation of cell division. A regulation of cell division. Okay, now this regulation is done by a set of protein. Okay, in all eukaryotic cells, cell cycle is governed by certain protein molecules. Okay, in all eukaryotes, cell cycle is governed by proteins called cyclins. There are proteins, these proteins are known as cyclins, okay, and there are some enzymes which are dependent on these cyclins. They are known as cyclin dependent kinases, okay, and cyclin dependent kinases. Okay, we commonly write it as CDKs. In all books you will find it as CDKs. So there are some proteins or reaction in these cyclins and cyclin dependent kinases. They decide whether cell will progress in the next phase or not. Okay, so these are the regulatory proteins, cyclins and cyclin dependent kinases. Okay, they control various phases of cell cycle. Control various phases of cell cycle. Okay, as well as regulate duration of cell cycle. Regulate duration of cell cycle. Okay, so there are three checkpoints throughout the cell cycle where this regulation it is done. So there are three checkpoints. Let's see which are those. First one, G1 checkpoint. G1 checkpoint. G2 checkpoint. And M checkpoint. Okay, G1 checkpoint, G2 checkpoint and M checkpoint. Okay, now let's see where are they exactly located. For that I'll draw one simple diagram showing cell cycle. Suppose this is our cell cycle. I just want to show you where exactly this regulation takes place. Suppose this is our M phase, this is G1 phase, S phase, G2 phase. So G1, this is S, this is G2, this is prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase and cytokinesis. Fine. So the first checkpoint, it is located at the end of G1 phase before cell enters in S phase. So here is our first checkpoint. Okay, this checkpoint, it is known as G1 checkpoint or G1 S checkpoint, whatever you can say, G1 S checkpoint. Now what it checked over here, obviously if checkpoint it is there, then obviously cell will check some things. So what it will check? Now G1 leads to which phase? G1 leads to S phase, synthetic phase, where DNA replication takes place. Again, very important event for cell. So cell checks all the things necessary for replication, like nucleotides, amino acid, ATP synthesis, proteins, enzymes are formed or not. Okay, so all the things necessary for DNA replication, whether they are formed or not, that should be checked here at G1S checkpoint. Okay, or G1 checkpoint. Okay, so it will check for damage to DNA. Check for damage. It will also check whether there is any damage to the DNA. If there is any damage, that should be repaired, and then only that DNA will follow the replication. Check for damage to DNA. Then synthesis of enzymes, proteins, ATP will be checked. Now this will activate. If all the things are well formed, then it will activate the cyclins. Okay, this cyclic then will active, or will active the cyclin dependent kinases, and then only cell will progress to the next phase. Now this activates cyclins. Okay, this cyclin causes activation of CDKs. Activation of CDKs, okay, and then these CDKs initiate S phase, promotes the cell to the S phase. Fine. Now the second checkpoint, that is located at G2 phase. Once all the things required for DNA synthesis are well formed, cell is allowed to undergo S phase. Now DNA replication is over. Now cell, it is preparing for cell division. So second checkpoint is located at the end of G2 phase, where now cell is about to enter for cell division. So this checkpoint is known as G2M checkpoint, okay, or G2 checkpoint. Fine. So this is G2 checkpoint. Now what it checked over here, whether DNA replication has done properly or not. Okay, so DNA replication will be checked. Then all the necessary enzymes, proteins, ATP for cell division, and tubulin synthesis. Okay, because we need spindle fibers for separation of chromatin. So whether tubulins are synthesized or not, that will be checked. Fine. And the third one, it is located at the end of metaphase, before cell enters in the anaphase, because anaphase, it is again very important. Even when there is a separation of chromatid, it could lead to some abnormalities if chromatids fail to separate properly. This could lead to some genetic disorder. So that phase, it is equally important, separation of chromatids. Okay, it should not result in the breakage of any part of chromosome, otherwise it will lead to several abnormalities. Okay, so third checkpoint is located at the end of metaphase, before cell enters into anaphase. Fine. So that is known as M checkpoint or spindle fiber checkpoint. M or spindle fiber checkpoint. M or spindle fiber checkpoint. Okay, it is present at the end of metaphase. What it checks? It checks whether all the spindle fibers are properly attached to centromeres or not. Present at the end of metaphase, it checks spindle fibers. Okay, it checks whether spindle fibers are properly attached to centromere or not. Okay, because for anaphase, or for the separation of these chromatids, spindle fibers have to be attached to centromere properly, then only these chromatids could be separated properly. Fine. So this is about the mitosis and the regulation of mitosis or the cell division. Fine. So now this is about the mitosis. Cell cycle, it is completed. Still, we have not started the meiosis. Meiosis we'll see in the next class. Fine. Along with this, I'll send you some additional points. Just some chemicals which could be act as a poison. Rarely questions will come. I explain you what is the effect of colchicine. Colchicine, it is a drug which interfere with the spindle fiber formation. Along with this, there are some chemicals which are known as the mitotic poison. So that's an additional point. You just read it. Question may or may not be come on that part. Fine. So today we completed mitosis as well as the regulation of cell cycle. In next class, we will complete meiosis. Okay, and after that we'll see some questions, some sort of numericals those can be asked from this part. Fine. I hope you all have understood. If you get any doubt related to this, just clear it, okay, today itself, because this topic is there for your major test and very few days are remaining. Fine. So don't keep any point pending. Along with this, go through NCRT also diagrams. In this lesson, so many diagrams are given for each and every step. So you have to study those diagrams from NCRT as well. Because for MCQ, for question, similar diagrams will come or same diagrams will come. So you should know which are those diagrams. Fine. So this is for the day. Now we will meet in the next class when we'll start the meiosis.